Hello, good evening and welcome to the National Basketball Arena. 16 players, 7 men's Premier League clubs and 4 provinces make up Hibernia Basketball. Tonight, they end a 22-year wait for European club basketball in Ireland as they host Bakken Bears of Denmark in the FIBA Europe Cup. This combined club side have played 3 away games in 3 different countries in the last 3 weeks in Group F of this competition. There's nothing in the win column just yet, but hope springs eternal with new players in the side and some key players returning from injury. We'll have more details on the starting lineups for you shortly. Ross O'Donoghue with you on commentary. Now I'd like to bring in our co-commentator for this evening, Matthew Hall. Matthew, this is a step up in every sense of the word, in occasion, in skill and in straight up basketball in the FIBA Europe Cup.
Yeah, good evening, Ross. Hugely exciting day for basketball fans in Ireland, and it's been a long time coming out of European competition. And whilst it's not a full international team, it's still that kind of standard that we've really missed on these shores for a little while. So I've not got the opportunity to actually watch the away games, only online as yourself at the games. Really looking forward to tonight to seeing the Bakken Bears. They look hugely impressive in the away game. And you see the crowd starting to build a bit, and hopefully there'll be a big crowd in tonight to see what's a really exciting prospect ahead.
We are less than 11 minutes away from the start of this game, tip off at 7:30. There's a real routine in how basketball players prepare for these kind of games. Everything in the next 10 minutes of their lives is prescribed, I guess you might say. Talk to us about the kind of stuff that's going through a player's mind at this point.
Every player will be different, but normally every player has a few things that trigger off their confidence, getting them ready for the game that they like to do, you know, with making shots in a row, making shots at a certain point, something that makes them know, yeah, I'm feeling good tonight. So they'll be trying to get through that whilst getting up and down the court, trying to get a sweat on so they're up to game pace by the time we get started. There's also the added things of the nerves in a situation like this. I'm sure some of the Hibernia players, not many of them would have played, maybe only Colin and Connor Grace would have played in such a high intensity international type environment at the arena. So it'll be the promotion outside of the National Cup will be the first time playing in such a game, so a little bit of nerves will play a bit of a case in the beginning of the game.
To those of you who are watching on our live stream this evening, and if you'd like to join the conversation, don't forget that you can contact Hibernia Basketball directly on Twitter via Hibernia B-Ball is the handle there, or hashtag FIBA Europe Cup. But if you'd like to get directly involved, Hibernia B-Ball is the one to get us on for the FIBA Europe Cup this evening. And a proud moment for those players as they're photographed on their home court, getting ready to represent. Of course, we know this isn't an internationally representative side, but their friends and family are in the seats for the first time this season. They know there's a real link to the clubs that they're representing right now, and we're starting to see, sure, of course, Denmark have come, and they've brought fairly decent support with them, but you get the sense that once things get underway here, that they won't be outdone for noise with the home crowd.
No, I think it's the Bakken Bears have come in their numbers, and hopefully that will inspire the Irish crowd. You know, the Irish are well able to shout and sing as well, so hopefully they'll get behind the Hibernia team. But, you know, hopefully we'll give them something to shout about in the early times as the team come out.
And here we go. Well, Kyle Hosford can't resist a smile. It's quite the entrance. They'll enjoy that one. And as the players make their way onto the court, now we get that sense of occasion. Now the crowd are realizing there's a game of basketball to be had and not just an evening out. And as they make their way through, it's a good time to talk you through the squad of 12 who'll be out for this evening. Number 4 is Adrian O'Sullivan for Hibernia. Number 5, Kyle Hosford. 6 is Roy Downey. Number 9 is Dylan Cunningham. Number 10, Kevin Lacey. 11 is Luke Thompson. 12, Colin O'Reilly, player coach. 14 is Connor Grace. Leamon Colbert at 15. Number 23 is Keelan Cairns. 32, Sean Van Zandt. And 33, Ronan O'Sullivan. Now, there are some players missing from that group. Kieran O'Sullivan took a very late injury late in the day, so he's going to be out for tonight at least. And Paddy Lyons, who has played a part in all 3 games to date, a knee injury has ruled him out. What does it mean to the squad as a whole? Obviously, those players haven't started in the games to date, but they have been integral members of the squad. Do the guys who know they're going to get serious minutes worry about injuries to others, or are those players just naturally selfish and focusing on themselves?
Yes. The unfortunate question is that there's a certain amount of selfishness in everything, and that every player out there will want to be given their best performance tonight. So, I mean, it's very difficult to worry about other people. I think that having played three away games and the way Colin has coached them over the last 3 or 4 months, I mean, they've become a bit more of a tight unit, more of a club side as the weeks go on. And I think, of course, that the players will feel a little bit for the players that sit on the side injured. So that will come into it a bit. But at this point now, they'll just be worrying about themselves and performing well and being ready to perform well in this game.
Also looking relaxed out there are the Bakken Bears squad. Their 12 pretty much unchanged from the side that played Hibernia basketball back on the 28th of October in Aarhus in Western Denmark. Number 4, Sebastian Peterson. Number 5, very much a man to watch, Carlos Bivia. 6, Aladine Barraquet. Number 7 is Jacob Nielsen. 8 is Thomas Lerke with a critical three-pointer in the game last time out. Mikael Plantin at number 9. Captain of Bakken Bears is number 10, Nikolai Iversen. Number 11, one of their go-to guys, Michel Jupp. Number 12, the darling of Denmark, Darko Jukic. 13 is Morten Salert. 14, you cannot miss him, the largest man in Denmark, Chris Christopherson, and their American, number 15, Keen Thoman. Maybe let's just take a couple of minutes to look at this Bakken Bears side, identify some of the threats, and see what we can also look forward to in this game. You've been taking a look at this lineup beforehand, Matt. Who are the ones to watch?
Yeah, we've had a quick look. I mean, from the first game, it was clear that number 12, Jukic, is one of their main players. Talking to their manager yesterday, they very much rate him as probably the best player in Denmark at the moment. So very much looking forward to seeing him in Mikael Jupp. They've got the second highest score in the Danish league at the moment. The Bakken Bears currently riding high, second in the league, having only lost one game. But Jupp has obviously been a big score for them, averaging 19 points a game. So he'll be, as you mentioned, really one of their main two guys. Bivia, the point guard, especially having watched a bit of the first game, Spanish guard, really smooth, as most of the Spaniards are, deceptively quick. He'll be difficult to guard off the dribble, and as most of the European players, really plays the pick and roll very well. So it'll be something we don't see too much of in the Irish league. So they really have to try and get a grip on that. I know that they've done quite a bit of work on that in practice, so that'll be something they'll be trying to get a hold of. At the shooting guards, they've got Larky, I think is how you pronounce it. You probably do a better job than me, but certainly from the first game as well, they showed that they had 2 or 3 players that really could hit the seat from outside as the game went on, and as Hibernia basketball got a little bit more tired. So it'll be something that they really have to come out fast for and really concentrate in the early games. I know Colin will be trying to take away their easy baskets early on, especially inside. You mentioned Chris Christopherson. I'm not sure if he'll start today. I don't think he started last time. Maybe he will this time. But certainly just his sheer presence at 7'3" will be a massive sight for us to stop. As you can see inside, we're struggling today without Martin Provisors, who's injured. So that will be a bit of a letdown for Hibernia basketball. So they might struggle a bit to guard him inside.
Looking then to Hibernia basketball, Matt. No Colin O'Reilly last Wednesday. An injury that ruled him out of action from the Shino Men's Championships in China back in July has really carried through there, and he's powered through in many ways, but he decided to rest himself for the game against Chez Nimberg, and then also sat out the Men's National Cup win over UL Eagles on Friday night. Just how important is his return to the side, so guiding not just from courtside but right in the middle of the action as well?
I think we saw that last year throughout the league where Demons went undefeated. Yes, he's a great coach, but he's also currently probably the best Irish player we have in the country. And, you know, we're not going to win too many of these games, we're going to compete in too many of these games without him on the floor. He's the kind of X-man in. We don't have too many players of his build and size and his skill level in the country. We have some good guards, some good big guys, but we really struggle with something inside for him. So he'll be massive today. And in the away game against Bakken, he really started off well, so I expect him to be really well marked at the start of the game. But if we can get him open and he can find his touch, hopefully he can keep us in the game early.
Of course, for Bakken Bears, their coach, Israel Martin, a hugely respected and experienced coach, but this is a maiden voyage for him very much in European basketball. Like, perhaps in many ways, this competition is a learning curve for everyone because it is in its infancy.
Yeah, I'd say so. I mean, it'll be new to him. I mean, the style that we'll be playing, he probably won't have seen too much of. And again, every time you go to a different country, styles are different. So it's a good learning curve for any coach, any coach coming into this kind of competition. I'm sure Colin's learned a lot in terms of coaching as well, as every game, whilst you prepare as much as you can before the game, you still have to coach a little bit more than during the game than you'd be used to in the league, because you're seeing something different all the time.
Coach Martin was very complimentary, actually, of the Hibernia Basketball Project. Now, maybe they were platitudes, but there is a lot of respect you required for what Hibernia Basketball is trying to do. We will have a minute silence shortly in respect of those lost in the terror attacks in Paris last Friday night. But just talk to us briefly about the fact that this is such a unique project in European basketball.
Yeah, it is, and it's, I mean, fair play to the Men's National League Committee putting this together. It's something we badly needed, is to get back into such a big competition. And, you know, I know the players that have put themselves forward and have committed to this programme have really learned a huge amount about, you know, about themselves, about the standard. And I'm sure that's stick on into their league games on the Saturday, just being playing with so much more speed and intensity that perhaps our league, because of the height and because of, you know, the lack of, it's not a professional league, doesn't see week in, week out. So you can see as the game's gone on, the players have really started to grow in themselves and playing to the best ability. And I'm sure they'll have nothing but positive things to say about the competition.
Final checks now for both coaches in the run-up to this game. It's about keeping it simple at this stage and maybe a little bit of positive reinforcement. Back and Bears will be playing in their more familiar darker colours. For Hibernia Basketball this evening, they'll be playing in their home strip, which is in fact in white. So Hibernia playing in white this evening, although green the obvious association. Players just making their way out onto the court now. Really, it's business time. To be fair to the Danish, they haven't just brought a professional outfit of players over here. It honestly looks like they've imported some professional cheerleaders all the way from Denmark this evening. That's quite the remarkable flag as well. It looks like it's made out of an ash tree. So we'll now pause very briefly for a moment's silence again to honour and pay our respects to the fallen in the attacks in France last Friday evening. And of course, we pay our respect to the French clubs involved in this competition as well. Just one extra minute in there to focus the minds and get ready for the 40 minutes of basketball that lies ahead. It's the FIBA Europe Cup Group F game between Hibernia Basketball of Ireland and Bakken Bears of Denmark. The starting five out on the floor for Hibernia Basketball. Five, Colin Hosford. It'll be Limon Colbert contesting the jump. Connor Grace, Sean Van Zandt making his first start for Hibernia Basketball with player coach Colin O'Reilly. For Bakken Bears in possession. And coughing that one up is the Spanish point guard, Carlos Vivia. The intended target was Michel Juff. The darling of Denmark, Darko Jukic at number 12. Captain Nikolai Iversen at number 9, Mikael Plantin. And first chance for Sean Van Zandt, parachuted into the squad as he was pretty much over the weekend, to feel out the opposition and get into it. Here's Connor Grace for Hosford, the captain. Back for Colbert. Might think about a deep two. He takes on Juff, pulls up and makes the two. And that's a good start for Hibernia Basketball. One of the things they've been missing to date is penetration, and they had it there.
Yeah, great to see Lamont going straight at them inside. Especially in the first games, I felt they could have gone inside a little bit more because they can't keep making threes. But great early basket to go straight at the offense is give them a bit of confidence early in the game.
And no surprise that Jukic is the one that gets the first one off for Bakken Bears. That one's short from Connor Grace, but Jukic put up 17 points in just 19 minutes in the game on October 28th. Another one who did well was Michel Jouff, but he misses on that occasion. Here's O'Reilly. Bit of confusion there between O'Reilly and Conor Grace. But that's a white ball. Hibernia will retain possession through Sean Van Zandt. I think O'Reilly was just looking to offload there. Here he is again. Takes it on himself this time. Jukic with the rebound. Will he go all the way? Fires it back straight into the hands of Colin O'Reilly. The break is on. Here's Kyle Hosford. Puts it back for O'Reilly. And O'Reilly says to Hosford, you know what? You could have finished that one yourself, because it gave plenty of time for Bears to get back and cover through Carlos Bivia.
Yeah, missed opportunity there by Hibernia, but really pleased with the start pace-wise that Hibernia have made. They've really got straight into this game really early, got a couple of nice looks at the basket and even some penetration, which we haven't seen too much from in the first couple of games, so I think they'll be pleased early on.
Van Zandt for Hosford sells the dummy. It's back with Colbert.
Great pass again there from Colbert. Yeah, really found the middle of the key there and got it inside to Conor Grace.
So, with just 2 minutes gone in this game, it's a bright start for Hibernia basketball. We know the Bears are slow starters. We've seen it in the previous game, and we know from the complaints of their coach, Israel Martin, he wants more out of their side in the first quarter, but this will suit Hibernia down to the ground. Jouff with the early miss. And it looks like Denmark have decided to go after the point guard, with Plantin trying to apply that pressure there onto Sean Van Zandt. And there were a lot of turnovers in the first game, and I think it just goes to show how important Van Zandt will be to this cause.
Yeah, he's a huge plus to the team, gives them another ball handler. You know, it's tough work, full court pressure all game long, tough getting the ball over the halfway line, and that's what causes turnovers late in the game. So Sean will give them that added impetus on the ball with Kyle and Roy Downey later on.
From a tactical point of view, how are these two teams shaping up?
Well, Bakken have come out with putting on full court pressure on defense, but so far Hibernia haven't had too much problems with that. And the big plus for Hibernia is with Colbert driving inside and the ball movement that Hibernia have had, they've really been able to get open shots, which is something that we haven't seen much of inside, kind of inside the key and inside the three-point line open shots in the first couple of games. So I'm sure Conn will be delighted with the start as they lead 4-0, but also defensively they really shut down the inside.
And O'Reilly picks up his first foul of the game. It's Jouff on Grace, who feeds Iverson. It's back with Jouff. And that's a shot clock violation, which will be very, very welcome for this Irish team, with Van Zandt on the break now. And still no score after almost 3 minutes of basketball for Bakken Bears, although they hit the break now with Plantin. He pulls up for three. Rebound misses. It's back with Iverson.
They need to get out to Plantin now. We saw him in practice staying in the last game. He really can stroke that three, so they can't afford to give him too many looks. But great defense. Oh, score the foul there.
Well, Bakken Bears were throwing up alley-oop passes when they were home and dry in the third quarter of the last game. Probably a little bit early in the game to be trying that kind of pass, Matt.
Yeah, good defense against Hibernia, but I think the one slight disappointment, I think, for Colin Hibernia is they've played really well, they've got open looks, but they've not been able to finish. So the score's 4-0 only, where, you know, they would hope to be up by 8 or so by now with some of the looks they've had.
And Michel Jouff gets Bakken Bears off the board. Double scores, we'll call it, for the sake of being optimistic, with 6.5 minutes to go in this first quarter. Here's Van Zandt. O'Reilly thinks about the three, but finds Conor Grace. It is all about finding the open looks here. Van Zandt turns the corner. That one's back with Bivia, this deceptively quick Spaniard. Looks like he has all the time in the world, but that's only because he creates it. Jukic with the drive. Earns the foul, misses the dunk. And let's make no bones about it here. Bakken Bears are the clear favourites in this game. But with a little bit of luck, which would include keeping the foul count down, you'd have to imagine, Matt, this team can expect to go deep into this game. But Plantin takes on O'Reilly. Pulls back for Jouff. And it's not just Hibernia who are missing with the open looks. Michel Jouff has missed a number of shots today. 4 minutes of this game gone. And a foul picked up there for Hibernia.
And here's, you have a look at that.
Second one for Limon Colbert. We'll have to keep an eye on that. So straight away, it's Keelan Cairns of Belfast Star who makes his introduction. I think that's a safe play by the bench.
Yes, you can see there just from the replay that he did. It looked like a soft call, but he did just catch the elbow, and a very good call from referee. Yeah, Lamont will be disappointed with that now because they played really good defense on Diop early, made him take some really tough shots. So they'll be disappointed to let him get off on the score sheet from the free throw line. But so far, Hibernia have played defense really well, but they need to convert some of the good opportunities they've created on offense.
And with 6 minutes to go in this first quarter, the sides are level for the second time in the game. And Backen Bears are back in contention, and on the ball through Darko Jukic coming in off the wing. And he went to finish himself, and that's the lead now for Backen Bears. He doesn't need a second opportunity, Jukic. Here's Hosford to O'Reilly. Grace now in the corner, Cairns doesn't get the look. Does get the fadeaway, that's a good basket off the bench for Keelan Cairns.
Yeah, nice move on Keelan. I like the fact that he put the ball on the floor to get into the key a little bit first, whereas in the previous games they've very much been living on the three-point line. So excellent basketball there, some good defense there from Connor Grace as Van Zandt's off on the break.
And does pick up the foul along the way, doesn't make the shot, but that's good confidence there from Van Zandt. No tentativeness for the fact that really is playing in competitive action for the first time in this game.
There you see a great stand under the basket from Connor Grace there. Put the pressure on Beaver and he managed to miss him. Roy Downey's about to check in for the first game for the first time today. I have to say, over the first three games of the campaign, Roy was really one of the standout players. He consistently was able to beat this man off the dribble, and hopefully he'll come to play again. He's had a really good start to the domestic season. And really looking for good things from him today.
And Van Zandt, successful with the first. Comes to Ireland after stints in the Finnish League and the NBA Development League. That one's swatted away by the largest man in Denmark, Chris Christofferson, is off the bench and playing for Backen Bears. This is Plantin. Swings it out for Jukic for three! Jouff now with the offensive rebound. He has Keelan Cairns for company. And just hooks that one over the Belfast Star forward for an 8-7 lead for Backen Bears. Conor Grace. And O'Reilly loses his footing and the ball as Christofferson feeds Vivia. Remember, O'Reilly made his first three consecutive three-pointers. A bit like that one in the first leg, and it gave major impetus to Hibernia in the first quarter. But now it's Backen with the initiative, and Hibernia call a timeout, trailing by four.
Yeah, and Hibernia just gave Jukic too many looks there. He missed the previous two from the three-point line, but a player as good as him, he's not going to continue to miss, and they just need to be wary of that, because that's... We're not going to score a huge amount of points there. You see him wide open on the three-point line. Not even anyone getting a hand out to him, which is tough because they're moving the ball well inside. But it's something they're going to have to keep an eye on. It'll be tough there. You see Colin talking to his troops. It'll be tough for them to stay in the game if they keep giving up threes. So defensively-wise, they started off well, but the last couple of plays have just given a couple of open looks, and that's something they need to quash pretty quickly.
Yeah, almost a good time to call that timeout just to reinforce that idea of getting out to players. And if Hibernia are going to do anything remarkable in this game, they're absolutely going to have to empty the tanks here at the National Basketball Arena. Much calmer descriptions going on from Coach Israel Martin, but he's very much a hands-on coach. He takes the training sessions right down to how the players should be stretching, warming up and warming down. And some words there for Chris Christofferson, who was such a catalyst in the last game. At 7'2", the longest man in Denmark, was uncontainable for Backen Bears. He could just basically do what he liked, and without necessarily being the scorer in chief for them in that second quarter, he did turn the game. Good pass from Grace to Cairns. Finds Van Zandt with a hard-working Plantin for company. Here's Cairns. Yeah. substitute for Hibernia Basketball. Roy Downey is in this game, a fearless player, but is guilty of the occasional turnover and gives this one back to Bakken Bears. Offers some genuine penetration for the Irish. And here we go, Christofferson. And that's textbook in terms of setup for Bakken Bears, but it doesn't come back to them, and it's with Van Zandt who fires that bullet like to Downey. Tries the drive but has to pull up short. But he does penetrate well for Hibernia. That one's over the top from Kevin Lacey for the three-point attempt, and Hibernia have to get back now because there's an intent about backing Bears at this point. Nice pass from Planthin. Vivier with all the time in the world calls the play, sets backing Bears in motion, but he'll have to get past Downey first, and he does. And that's a let-off for Hibernia Basketball because Jeff had all the time in the world to hit that three-pointer. And that will be a concern for Hibernia. Keelan Cairns, though, knows how to punish time and space. And he gives a double-digit score for Hibernia. Now they trail by just a point.
Great ball movement there. And all started from Downey's excellent rebound. He put his body on the line there to get the fast break started. And that's what Hibernia are going to have to do. They can't take one single play off or one moment off. They've got to keep playing the whole time. And again there you'll see it. Weakly lays that up and the whole crowd boos with disappointment.
Barely had to get off his feet that time, the big Dane. It's a 3-point lead for Bakken Bears with 2.5 minutes to go in the first quarter.
And a couple of turnovers just starting to creep in with the passes with Hibernia. See Colin there disappointing the sideline. He'll be very much hoping they can cut that down. They can't afford it and it ends up in another Dukic 3-point shot.
And Dukic takes his tally in this game to 6 points and a 16-10 lead for Bakken Bears. Here's Downey to Cairns, goes for three. This one's short and Grace can't get a hand on it. It's back with Vivier. Downey gets out to him, but it's not enough. And Bakken are putting daylight between themselves and their Irish hosts with a minute 50 to go in this first quarter. They lead by 19 points to 10.
Yeah, you just see that the intensity just drops that little bit from Hibernia on defense, and a team like this will punish you with a great drive from Van Zandt there.
Well, they do that week in, week out in the colours of Belfast Star. Van Zandt and Keelan Cairns combined for a much needed deep two for Hibernia Basketball. And we'll need something else because confidence will have a lot to say in this game, and if Hibernia can't generate some very quickly, they might find themselves in trouble as Keelan Cairns picks up the defensive rebound to feed Sean Van Zandt. Can't get around Vivia, and Grace can't make the three. And that's hang time for Michel Jouff as he puts Bakken Bears ahead by 9 points with 52 seconds left to go in this first quarter. It's all too easy for the Bears at the moment.
Yeah, the intensity is getting to Hibernia a little bit now. They really need to dig in for the last 42 seconds of this quarter and just try and stay in the game as a foul is called there. But very much you've seen the last three or four shots from Hibernia, there's been absolutely nobody inside the three-point line, which has been the case in some of the earlier games, and that's where we struggle behind a little bit, especially with Colbert going out.
And Roy Downey picked up the foul there as Bakken Bears charged towards the basket, but Jouff devastating from 2 inches. And with Hibernia on team fouls now for the rest of the quarter, they'll cough up 2 shots at the charity stripe every time the whistle's blown. And can Vivier punish both? No, he can't, thanks to the good work of Conor Grace on rebounding against Christofferson. Here's Kevin Lacey with 2 for company. Only spills it as far as Christofferson. Into the game for Bakken Bears is Thomas Lerke and indeed Morgan Saylerts. And another miss from 3-point range for Bakken Bears. There's 12 seconds to go in this quarter. So Vivier will calm it down and generate one last opportunity. Has he called the play in himself? Well, Carlo Nicolas Bivia times that one to perfection as he feeds Michel Jouff for another easy left-handed finish for Bakken Bears. They lead Hibernia by double scores here at the end of the first quarter, 24 points to 12. Matt, there's a gap already opening up. It's disappointing the manner in which it's opening up at this stage. Where's the way back in the second quarter?
I think Colin will be really pleased in the first 4 or 5 minutes, but you can see the intensity's dropped. It's not necessarily the intensity drop, but the level that Bakken Bears play with consistently has become a bit of a problem. They've started to get open shots, and Hibernia haven't been able to keep up that pace. A huge thing was Lamont Colbert. His second foul, he was really putting the clamps a little bit on Diouf and making him take long jump shots. I mean, since we've seen then, he's got a dunk. He's been fouled going to the basket and a nice little short hook. And that's really been the key to opening up their three-point game, of which we see they can make them. And the trio of Bieber and Dukic and Diouf have really started to put Hibernia under pressure.
And that last basket probably summed up a lot of what Bakken Bears have been so strong on in this first quarter, timing and accuracy.
Yeah, so here you see the pick and roll, and this has been happening all game there. And it was Keelan Kearns on that occasion. He chose to sat back, which is probably something they've worked on, sat back in the key against the pick and roll. But it gave a player like Bieber a chance to turn the corner as he comes off pick and roll, being chased by, I think it was Horsford then. And then really it's 2-on-1 with a three-point shooter in the corner. I think on that time he passed the three-point shooter, but I mean, I think for Hibernia to stay in the game against the screen and roll, they're really going to have to do a better job of getting up. That big guy has to put a bit more effort on and get up and at least trap and push or squeeze, whichever they want to do. I mean, you'll see a lot of the Danish guys, they'll deny the screen and roll and push them to the corner and not let the screen happen. But if we continue to do that, it'll be a long game for us. So hopefully we'll be able to pick up on that in the second quarter.
The second quarter and a chance to refresh for Hibernia basketball. And I don't think we've seen Van Zandt shoot the ball just yet. He's been anxious to find his teammates on his debut, but that's a silly turnover.
And there we see what I'm talking about there. The way they defended that screen and roll, they denied the screen and roll, didn't let them use the screen, and it ended up in a turnover. And that's, you know, something that they practice a lot in these European teams.
That's Peterson for Jubb.
And again, that
simple tip in there for Chris Christopherson.
Again, that wide open jump shot came out of the screen and roll then. Not too well defended by Hibernia, and I'm sure Colin will pick it up on this and ask him for a few changes.
And another turnover in possession for Hibernia basketball as Lerka looks. Well, he looked for Jouff, but it came back to him and he was happy to finish. That's a 16-point lead now after just 11 minutes for Bakken Bears. Hosford on the charge for Grace. That's that one, does the big Temple Oak man, and a much needed response there for Hibernia basketball.
Yeah, when we do create open 3-point shots, we've really got to hit a high percentage. That's what's going to keep us hanging around. It's great defense there from Grace as he's buoyed by his last 3-point shot.
And a substitution we needed to see as Lamont Colbert checks in, but this was a timely basket as Lerka did the business there.
It's actually great defense by Grace, got a hand on the ball and been unlucky with the bounce in the end. The offensive foul there is called on Big Christopherson on the screen and roll.
Not something you'd know much about, Matt, but the big man doesn't get much protection in these games.
Well, I hope not in this particular case, but no, it tends to be for those offensive fouls, the referees are always looking for that, because it's something the big men like to do a bit, is just leave their bum out or put their leg out on the screen and roll. So the
Grace working hard. Here's O'Reilly for Van Zandt. Good jump shot from Sean Van Zandt. And that constitutes a run for Hibernia basketball as they follow up the three-pointer with a two by the Belfast Star man. It's inside for Christopherson. And that is route one as far as basketball is concerned. And Bakken Bears take their total to 30.
Yeah, good to see Van Zandt let the ball go. We haven't seen any shooting or anything offensively from him apart from playing the point, so we'll need him to do a little bit more. But Colbert was powerless there with the two fouls inside against Christopherson.
That's Colbert back in and shooting from outside. He'll need to be closer to the basket if he's to be of best use to the combined club side. Salerts fires that one out to Peterson. It's backward Salerts. Good rebound from Lamont Colbert to feed Van Zandt. Already looks stuck for options as he takes on Lerka. Colbert to Hosford. Foul called on Kyle Hosford. And it'll be white possession. Vincent taking control in the inbounds.
Yeah.
Just saw Peterson got his hands caught in the cookie jar there.
Yeah, and good to see some penetration there. They started off the game with a lot of penetration, getting into the key area, and that's kind of subsided a little bit as the game's gone on and tiredness has crept in from defense a little bit. So great to see that. Great to see that from Kyle there. Good foul call.
And back in Bears gather. Through Lerke. Goes all the way himself. And Conor Grace is much aggrieved that the foul wasn't called for the charge there. And it opened right up for back in Bears.
Yeah, he was well outside the charge circle. Almost certainly a charge there. He was very unlucky there because he went straight into him and it ended up an easy basket. But some good defense a couple of times in Conor. He put his body on the line here.
Miss for Sean Van Zandt. Gathered by Morten Sallerts. Inside for Geoff on Grace. Gets turned. And that won't count.
Yeah, Connor's had an unlucky minute there. He's got a very soft foul against one of the biggest players in the court after not getting the call himself. As you see it there, maybe a little touch with the hand on the hip, but you know, I don't think that put him off at all. But here we see where the injuries with Jason Kleen out of the squad and also Provisner has got injured this week. It's going to hurt Hibernia a little bit as they hit lockdown of three.
And the youngster for Bakken Bears gives them an 18-point advantage with 6:27 to go. Sebastian Peterson. Time and space for the youngster. Has played underage for Denmark. And a number of players on the Bears side with underage or junior international experience for their country. Two guys with the big experience for Bakken Bears would be Chris Christofferson, number 14 you've seen, and their captain Nikolai Everson, both of whom have played at the National Basketball Arena before, although you do have to go back to 2005 for that particular game. They lost it, so they're zero wins to date. There's a long way to go in this game at the National Basketball Arena in Tala. Interestingly, of the current Hibernia crop from that 2005 side, just Conor Grace was present in Dublin 24 on that day. Colin, that little bit later to the international scene as he rallies his troops now, trying to come back into this game. And you can see there's a couple of players there. The shoulders have dropped that little bit. Hosford hasn't maybe put up. I don't think he's put up a shot as of yet. Hibernia take pride in finding the open shooter, but players have to create something for themselves as well, much like O'Reilly.
Yeah, the back end defense at the guard spot have been very strong right from the offset, so it's been difficult for them, but they need to keep persisting at trying to get the ball inside as Grace goes there.
Here's Lerke. Pulls up, hits the three. And that has the travelling faithful all too happy they made the trip. Here's Conor Grace. Colbert finds Van Zandt. And that's a good bank shot from Sean Van Zandt. And a timely score for Hibernia, although it's still double scores.
Great backdoor cut from Van Zandt. I mean, it'll take him a little bit of time to get into the offense. He's new to the squad this week, so he wouldn't have had too many training sessions and getting used to Coach O'Reilly's system, but great backdoor cut there. Easy basket to finish.
And Lerke looks like a guy playing for a contract as he shoots willingly and often. That's an excellent reverse layup there from Conor Grace. And make no bones about it, this Hibernia team will play for the 40 minutes.
Yeah, fabulous fast break there. Great awareness by Conor O'Reilly and great finish. Taking Jukic out of the play.
With the miss that time, and here's O'Reilly for Grace. And that one just was fingertips away from Limon Colbert, and good thinking from his CNS UCC Demons teammate. It was Jukic who just got hands on it.
And you really see the blueprint for success for Hibernia there is the get the ball off the backboard and get down the floor quick. A lot easier said than done against this kind of talent and when they've been put under so much pressure defensively. But here you see from Colin. Great pass. That's a superb finish there from Conor Grace. He goes under the hoop and takes Duke's long arms out of the play.
And that'll have to constitute a run, or the closest we can get to one at this point, 4-0. And Everson straight away cuts that one back. The Bakken Bears captain, the glue guy of this Danish side, makes it 40 points to Bakken Bears 21 for Hibernia. And here's Kevin Lacey for the Irish to Colbert. Vincent continuing to grow into this game. Good pass from Grace to Hosford. Hosford thinks about the drive. That's a shot clock violation for Hibernia, and the away fans love that one. And that was a first attempt for Hosford from anywhere in this game, and he'll be disappointed that that was the end result. Looks like we're going to have a change for Hibernia. Roy Downey's going to come in for Hosford there. And Downey, we've seen already in this game, and we're looking for positives. We're looking for that deeper penetration. That we're looking for Conor Grace to do what he's just done and get on the end of things. He is our power forward, I guess you could say, and the tallest man on the side. Lerke for Everson. And here's Downey, feeds Colbert. And that's an excellent score on the break, and Downey already making his presence felt with the assist for Colbert. And we need this guy in the game, Matt.
Yeah, great pass from Roy. Excellent effort on the defensive pause that time. It really was a five-man effort rebounding, and it was the biggest guy on the floor that got down the court quickest. And we need those easy points. You know, we can make a threes eventually when we get left open, but we need easy points to keep us in the game.
Roy Downey was top scorer, took the game high in the round two game against Typhoon with 16 points. Grace just minds that red line that would call a backcourt violation to feed Lacey. Looks up, finds Limon Colbert. Vivia got hands in that, but it's presented for Downey with the jump shot. And to be fair, Hibernia over the last couple of minutes have been more than a match for their Danish visitors.
Well, I think it's been clear from the offset that when we're playing well and when we can concentrate for the whole shot clock at both ends, we're well in the game. But it's just the times we fall asleep playing at this speed and intensity for such a long period is something the players aren't that used to. And just the lapse in concentration are the big reason for the 15-point deficit at the moment. But great good rebound from Grace.
Good recovery for Roy Downey. And the teams are officially on par for this second quarter.
And eventually Conor Grace gets the call there. Third time he's put his body on the line under the hoop. And this time the referee's going on his side. Great defense from Conor as Bakken call a timeout.
And an enforced timeout it was too. 13 points between the sides. Hibernia trailed by 12. 7 minutes and 15 seconds ago. And a comeback in the latter half of this second quarter has brought them back into contention. It was around this time in the game back in October 28th, the sides were in fact level at 29 points apiece. But of course, what follows next is one of the more forgettable events in Irish basketball history, as a 22 run put the game absolutely beyond Hibernia basketball's reach.
Yeah, and Hibernia very much got back in the game. There's been a few loose balls here. We see there Conor Grace really puts his body on the line, gets right in front of it. Viva's looking for the foul, but Conor was standing perfectly still, and this time he got the call from the referee. And it's those kind of calls, and I mean, I think Downey's first basket that gave him the confidence came from a loose ball. It was a bad pass across, they tipped it, it fumbled, but Roy was quickest to it, got the basket, and that gave him a little bit of confidence, and he made the three next for five quick points. And I think from last week's game against UL, Roy made a couple of threes in that, I think he finished with 16 points. He's obviously playing well, and that 5 points give them that little bit of confidence now. If they can come out of this timeout and continue this little run, you know, hopefully we'll get back in the game for halftime.
Of course, it's just dawned on us as to why it looks like the Danish support had to take down a tree somewhere in West Dublin to make their flag. It is, of course, because they probably couldn't get one on the flight over here. It's Kevin Lacey to Colbert. Van Zandt with Lerke for company. Good screen, Connor Grace. Nice rebound by Kevin Lacey. Finds Downey, who pulls up for two. It's back with Colbert. Good rebounding here from Hibernia. Presents another chance with 10 seconds in the shot clock for Connor Grace. On Iverson, the two veterans. Oh, we wanted to see that one go in for Connor Grace. Off the glass, it's back with Vivia. Finds himself all alone in there, and that was that backing off in the paint that you'd referred to earlier on, but that one played right into backing Bear's hands.
Yeah, you see it there off the screen of Moldy, can turn the corner, and gets to go right at Connor Grace as the point guard against the big guy. He's unlucky there, he's got his arms up, but you know, you take a risk when you're one-on-one in there. You just see the big difference there is we had three great looks when we really moved the ball well, some penetration, open looks, didn't go, got the rebound, another look, but they didn't quite fall, and then back and come straight back down and punish us down the other way.
Vivier with the bonus. Puts 16 points between the sides with 2 minutes left to go to the half. Van Zandt for Downey. And the presence of the second Bear in there was enough to put the young Corkman off his game. As Kyle Hosford, the captain, comes in. Here's Downey. And with Iverson and Vivia so close for company, he did give Downey cause for hesitation. Plantin feeds Jukic. Inside for Jupp. It's behind the big Senegalese forward. It's Van Zandt now. That one's way over the top from Kevin Lacey. It was good work from Van Zandt. That's what he does. First star penetrates and kicks it out. And an uncharacteristic mistake from Jukic gives the ball back to Hibernia.
Yeah, a massive minute and a half to go now in this game, in this half. With the lead at 16, if we can get it down anywhere near, you know, even if we got down another basket, just give them, you know, that last little mini run will give them the confidence there. If they can get it down to 12, 11 points, it'll just give them that confidence to have a little goal in the second half and let Colin go in with some positiveness into the halftime break.
Colbert, Mike Lacey. There's Colbert. Big rejection there from Jupp, but illegally so, says the referee. And Colbert is adamant there was a lot going on there as he looked to drive inside. And statistically, Hibernia are in the top half of the stats table in terms of conversions from the free throw line. And clearly, Leamon Colbert is no stranger to cowbells, as the away fans can't do what they want to do and put the big American off his game. Misses with the second, though. And there's just 65 seconds left to go in this second quarter. And can, at the very least, Hibernia surpass their first half total from the first game. Jukic in time and space.
Great effort from Van Zandt there, didn't give up on the play. Early on we talked about those wide open threes, but he was never going to get to the ball, but he really closed out well, put a bit of pressure on Jukic there and ended up with, I believe, an air ball.
It's more fun to chant than it is to say, to be fair, Matt. Well, here we go, Hibernia in possession, looking to put some positivity on the scoreboard and into their mindset as they head for the dressing room at halftime.
Yeah, a little bit of time just going back on the clock, an extra second or so, but huge play here for Hibernia now just to try and cut into this lead.
Van Zandt once again with Plantin for company. Takes him on and beats him on the left hand. Somehow makes it back to Connor Grace. That one rattles off the front of the rim and it's back with backing Bears and Carlos Bivia. 30 seconds to go. We know that Bivia's more than happy to run down the clock to the last possible second on the shot clock. That's in and out and Colbert gathers the rebound. What can Hibernia do here? It's Kevin Lacey. And another chance for Hibernia to make some gains from the free throw line.
Yeah, good break there, two on one. We saw a little bit here, tendency from Lacey there. Normally he would just, in the lead, he'd go straight up and over Bivia there. Doesn't have the athleticism, but still got fouled, used his body well. So hopefully he can knock down these two and cut the lead a little bit for Hibernia.
And the GCD Swords Thunder shooting guard is successful with the first. Did play in the reverse fixture, makes two from two, and this is his first appearance since that trip to Aarhus, and he's back in action.
That's okay, not a bad foul, not in penalties to be sidelined, better off slow the ball down. Bivia had a clear lane to the basket there, so 10 seconds of defense here. As you see the foul here, he just splits between Grace, who must be exhausted at this point. I think he's played the entire half so far.
And Carlos Bivia with a dagger three to close out the half, but here's Van Zandt. And a supreme rejection from Michel Chouf means that at the halfway mark, it's Hibernia basketball, 30 points. Bakken Bears, 46. Matt, we have surpassed the first half total from the game back in October 28th, but there is 16 points between the sides. Was there enough in the last couple of minutes of the second quarter to generate that much needed positivity for Hibernia?
Well, I think Colin should be very positive. I'm sure he will be. They show glimpses of massive improvement as the tournament's gone on. They've shown that at times they can compete, they can score, they can defend them. It's just those slight lapses, and when we stall on offense, we don't have the ball movement or anything like that. That's really been the major issue. They can cut out those mistakes. I'm sure it can cut down, but the thing you have to also know that is the Bakken Bears are a quality outfit. They look a quality outfit at every single position, even when they bring the bench on. So that makes it even harder to come back into the game. But I think Colin will be delighted if they can just keep up this intensity, keep the scoring going. Maybe another 30-point half would really be the target, I would think. You know, they don't want to drop what's happened in the other games. They've struggled to score in the second half, maybe a little bit. So hopefully if he could repeat this in the second half, I'm sure he'd be fairly pleased.
You mentioned there the likes of Connor Grace and a couple of players who've gotten a lot of court time in the last 20 minutes. There is a bench there. We're not the deepest squad in the FIBA Europe Cup, but who do you think could come in and potentially make some kind of impact?
Well, I mean, the thing is that they, even in the Islands League as a whole, at the 4 and 5 spot, we struggle a little bit for players with experience. You know, Connor has the experience. He's played in Europe. He's played internationally. He's seen a lot of this type of basketball. Pick and roll basketball, as I talked about earlier on, isn't huge in the Irish Basketball League because we don't have the 6'10" players too much. So it's not something that they get bothered to too often. A lot of switches take place, but it's really bothered Hibernia first half.
We do have a 6'9" player in there, Connor Grace, one of those players who's gotten all of that court time in the first half. And a lot of what has been good about the Irish has been through the Dubliner.
Yeah, and a great finish there from Connor. You saw him, he's run the floor. You know, he's really put his body on the line at both ends, defensively and offensively. He got up and down the floor and really put in a good shift in that first half and kept him in the game a little bit. But you'd expect that from a man of his experience and his quality.
Of course, dealing as these players do in an amateur league, week in, week out, they're not used to the idea of guys coming in off the bench desperate for minutes because they're playing for contracts and they're playing for their livelihoods. You know, it can be just a case of putting, you know, when once the game is in control and once the result is beyond doubt, it is a case of running the bench more for exposure as anything else. With the professional sides that Hibernia have been coming up against week in, week out, there's been no let up.
Yeah, exactly. And you see it from back, and they're not making subs to give people a run. They're making subs because people can play. You know, you saw off the bench earlier, I think it was Tommin came off the bench and hit two back-to-back threes, and another one of the young guys hit a three off the bench. So even when they make substitutions, the quality isn't going down too much, and they're keeping that intensity up on defense for the whole game, which makes it difficult. There's never any respite for Hibernia. You know, we talk about our bench. We've got some great young players in our bench, and Ronan O'Sullivan, Adrian O'Sullivan, Paddy Lyons on the bench there. Oh, actually, he's injured today. But I mean, the Premier League's better younger players are there, but they wouldn't have played against this kind of level so far. So it's huge experience for them and a huge learning curve for them, which can only do them a lot of benefit in the future.
It is the second meeting of this side in the last 3 weeks. The last time they met, it was a comfortable victory for backing in the end, but there was one or two shocks along the way and plenty to give Hibernia a reason to think they could put in a performance at Tala. We're going to leave you for a couple of minutes with a look back on that game from October 28th, but for now at the National Basketball Arena, it is Bakken Bears 46, Hibernia 30. Join us for a few minutes in the second half.
Altså en mesterskabssæson med Södertälje i Sverige. Men lidt af en overraskelse, han endte i Danmark igen. Og også 3 point til Ierne. Og så bringer sig foran for første gang i kampen.
Danskulvet, som sikkert mange af jer ved. Så han er, og så er han også rendt ind i noget sygdom, og så han er ikke helt været med i de store forberedelser. Så det bliver spændende at se, hvor meget vi får at se til ham.
Og igen Colin O'Reilly. Og 3 point. Så et rigtig, rigtig godt skud.
Ja, der var en grund til, at han blev kåret som den bedste danske spiller, sidst han spillede blandt her i hallen.
Det var altså for 3 sæsoner siden, da han tørnede ud fra dem, der slog Bakken, vil jeg sige, DM-finalen i sidste sæson.
Om holdene lige skal føle hinanden på her til at starte med. Ej, han var godt nok fri.
Og igen 3 point. Colin O'Reilly. Han er brandvarm.
Hvor jeg mener, han ramte 7 ud af 8 træer i en kamp. Det er bestemt ikke dårligt.
Og der kan man godt gå glad i seng. Typhoon fra Slovenien og Nymburk fra Tjekkiet. Roy Downey sætter 2 point. En dyb 2'er fra ham. Lidt selv lige ud.
Det var lige før, det hooks jeg, at det så nemmere ud, end det dunk, han var er du ærgerlig, aflevering ikke helt var der, skulle han skulle gribe den under kurven, fordi...
Godt spillet, Martin Frivors.
Det er skidt, man er egentlig hjemme 4 mand, og så får man ikke at finde manden lige under kurven.
Godt gået til kurven og får et ekstra straffekast ud af det. Roy Downey.
Nu skal de have løje med ham, fordi nu er han blevet varm.
Godt spillet. Ja, Colin O'Reilly.
Det er utroligt, at der kan være så meget blok for ham.
Han havde blok for ham, ja. Og så bliver den stjålet i den anden ende også. Colin O'Reilly. 2 point har ham.
Der er Kristoffersen på banen, som har 2 fejl, så det er vigtigt, at de ikke samler deres tredje fejl op.
De leverer sig godt bag 3-pointslinjen. Fantastisk spil fra Bakkenbærs, der bliver afsluttet af Darko Jukić.
Der var det. Det er ikke første gang, de har lavet det play der, men den her gang, der virkede det.
Han viser han altså, hvorfor. Mikael Bilou. Virkelig en spiller, Darko Jukić. Sammen med flere andre faktisk fra Bakkenbærs, der kan trække nogle mennesker i hallen.
Men det var måske også en fornuftig måde at stoppe trash-talken på fra Ierne. Det er bare at vise det på banen.
In your face.
Ja, præcis. Og de lærer sikkert også rigtig meget af det her, og trækker erfaring til sig, så jeg tror bestemt ikke, man skal dømme dem ude endnu.
Jeg tror, de lige fordoblede deres point totalen i tredje kvart. Ladin Barca er endnu en af de unge spillere. Nu får vi lige 3 point. Sidste års Euro Challenge, der var han faktisk på et tidspunkt den bedste trepointsspiller i turneringen. Ja. Det var han. Og nu har de fået skud til varme.
Ja, det er det der med ikke at blive lullet i søvn, skal man herfra.
Tis sekunder tilbage på skuddet, og gør han meget godt, den store. Hvor han så igen den lettiske center, og det gør han godt igen med den dybe toer.
Ja, anden korter.
Der er altså lidt mere spænding i gruppens andet opgør. Går han til kurven, Provisors kom godt i gang her.
Ja, der ligner han en lille skoledreng, Chris Christoffersen.
Ja, det.
Måske ikke spillemæssigt, men i hvert fald højdemæssigt. Kovac poster op mod Chris Christoffersen, ja. Så der er med 2 point i.
Og det er netop en god demonstration af, hvad second chance point er. Eller third chance i det her tilfælde. Der var ikke meget kan lide ved ham, at han er så uimponeret. Og går bare direkte ind til opgaven og spiller.
Måske også en meget god kamp for ham at komme ind og få sin debut, hvor der ikke er helt vildt meget pres på.
Ja, bestemt.
Skal vi så holde nerven lidt i ro. 20 sekunder har de tilbage i Ierne, før de kan få fred.
Bakkenberg og Stine på samme tid kan strække armen i vejret og fejre to meget, meget, meget sikre point. FIBA Europe Cup. Se hvad de kan finde frem til det kommende opgør i FIBA Europe Cup. Men i hvert fald en meget, meget sikker sejr til Bakkenberg, så de er nu på 6 sejre, 6 mulige i den nye sæson, altså også en sejr i en kamp i Europa. Så godt ser det altså ud for Bjørnene Forhus for det videre eventyr i Europa. Det.
Twenty minutes of basketball remain in the first European club tie to take place on the island of Ireland in 22 years. It was in 1993 when Gemma St. Vincent's had games against Icelandic and Dutch champions. It was a knockout stage back in those days, and they made it through to the second round. It's a group phase of six games in the FIBA Europe Cup for Hibernia Basketball in Group F. Three away games down. This is the first of three home games to come between now and the 2nd of December at the National Basketball Arena. Matt, you've had a look at the stats and the box score from the first half. What can be drawn from it?
I think it's clear with the score and spread. I mean, the guys we talked about, Vivia, Djukic and Diouf, have 10, 12 and 8 points for Back and Bears. So they've been the big scorers, but I mean, I think Vivia's really been the playmaker off the screen and roll that really have Hibernia struggling at the moment. In terms of turnovers, points off turnovers, it's 10-9 in favour of Bakken. Points in the paint is 22-16 in favour of Bakken, which I'm sure Colin will be fairly pleased with due to the fact that we're undersized in that department.
Matt, what we're going to need in this game is a little bit more of the fight that we've seen at stages in that first half. We talked about them emptying the tank. They're going to have to give it everything.
Yeah, you see it on the replay there, loose ball early on as Colin just lost his footing as the game restarts here. But yeah, definitely the ball movement, getting around the screens and defending screen and roll is something that hopefully Hibernia can really pick up on the second half as Colbert's back inside to do a job on Diouf.
Second half underway and already Michel Diouf takes his tally to 14 points in the game. The big Senegalese has been doing serious damage inside against a team with no recognised centre or indeed power forward, I guess you could say. Lacey for three. This one's back off the front of the rim and back with Back and Bears, who lead by 18 points now. Iverson for Jukic. And that is a third personal foul for Connor Grace, who's shown combative skills and indeed skillful scales in the first half. And that is foul trouble now for one of Hibernia's most effective players. Bivia has time and space, still can't punish the slip from Van Zandt, who's on the ball now. And leads with the left as Van Zandt, but takes it on his right for Lacey. Here's Grace. That one's in and out, but it's back with Limon Colbert. And Colbert will go to the line as well. And good to see that there's still no fear in the face of Michel Diouf for Limon Colbert.
No, you see it here. Great rebound from, got good position there, Colbert. Just uses his body well and gives him the eyebrow fake. And the big man goes for it, hook, line and sinker. And a great finish there from Colbert to make a 3-point play, hopefully.
And that one's short from Colbert. But the first two count and they're more than welcome. So just 2 points scored by both sides at these early stages in the third. Here's Plantin. And they're slinging around now, the Danes.
Yes, Hibernia have just slipped into a zone there, 2-3 zone by the look of it.
And you can call them professional basketballers as long as you want, but that's an air ball in anyone's language.
Yeah, that's the second one there. You see, when we do get pressure on them, he's as vulnerable as anyone to missing. But Hibernia slipped into a 2-3 zone then, as you see the miss. And it worked on that occasion. We'll see how it works next time down when they use it next time. Maybe they'll switch up between man and zone, which is something they've done in previous games on scores and misses.
Here's Hosford on the drive. It's a turnover for the Hibernia captain. Although the turnover count was pretty solid in the first half. Just 8 turnovers in the first 20 minutes of basketball, which would be a competition low at the halfway point in the FIBA Europe Cup action to date. Bivia for Plantin. Van Zandt gets his hands in it. What can he do? You can put the ball in any way you like from that range. It's still 2 points and it's a good reaction. And lots of positivity now in the Hibernia basketball bench as they welcome Van Zandt and his four teammates with open arms. That's a good finish. Although he had the time and space to do it, we've seen them missed. And particularly when the stakes are high, and particularly when you're low confidence, they don't always go in.
Yeah, and we saw from that steal there, Van Zandt, I mean, he's obviously new to the team. It'll take him a little time to get used to it, but I really like to see him really just go help there on attack. And we saw that last play of the first half when he got blocked. That was the first time we really see him put the afterburners on. And I feel that they could struggle to guard him a little bit if he really went after them a little bit.
It was Back and Bears that called that timeout, and it was after that switch to the zone defense that you've mentioned. Are they going to move things around?
Yeah, you'd expect there. You see coach there just drawing out a couple of plays. You'd expect them. They move the ball very well. They've got good shooters. So it'll be interesting to see how, if Colin stays in or if he switches from his timeout. It certainly worked there. You wouldn't expect it to work too long, but it certainly worked for the first couple of minutes. They switch in and out. It just confused Bakken long enough that got them a couple of scores, and they've cut the deficit from the half down to 14.
Hibernia returned to the stage with 14 points between the sides. And now her improvement on the 16-point margin it was at the halfway mark. And Bakken Bears go to work through their Spanish point guard and that eager wingman for them, Planton. There's plenty of work on defense. And that may not have been the play they called up, but it's 3 points nonetheless for Bakken Bears.
Yes, they did stay in the zone. They pushed up the court, put a bit of pressure on, which really worked early on the offense. But again, Vivian's obviously a quality point guard. And just by this time there to get open three.
Once again, Hosford pulls out of the shot. We need more from the live wire point guard. Here's Connor Grace. And that one is a foul for Mikael Plantin of Bakken Bears, who have taken their tally through to the 50-point mark at this point. It's through the half century. They managed 96 in the first outing, their highest tally to date. And here's Grace for three. With that darting style of his, it's not successful in this occasion. And he had just about enough time to admonish himself before getting back on defense. Iverson. Bounce inside. Juff was happy to overcomplicate it. Missed the bucket, but does go to the line.
Yeah, great pass there from Vivian. That's Connor Grace. I think that's his fourth foul. And first time Connor's come off, and that's really going to hurt Hibernia. I see Connor hasn't gone back in yet, so I'm not sure if he is struggling a bit with his injury, but that's a huge loss with Connor Grace going. We've seen from the start of the game with the best five out there, or we've really been a match for them for a little bit, but we can ill afford either Lamont or Connor to step out, because that really, really hurts us size-wise with the smaller players. Whilst Keelan is a large body, he's more of a wing player shooter than he is a straight-up five.
Chuff with a swing and a miss off the first. Makes no mistake with the second, and that's Bakken Bears out to an 18-point lead now. And it was Keelan Cairns who checked in for Connor Grace. Cairns is also coming for Colbert in this game, so it does leave Colin O'Reilly short on options. And that's what we've been looking for from Kyle Hosford. It's that bit of never say no Cork style. And a good bank shot for his first bucket of the game. Hibernia trail, 36-52. Here's Planton. Being chased now by Hosford. Colbert closes in. Juff open at the elbow. And a good intervention there from Colbert, and it's eventually cleaned up and back. Bit of confusion there between Van Zandt and Colbert, but it's Van Zandt now on the charge. Gets around, and that's more of that aggression that we've been looking for in this game. Good reach in here from Colbert, who's a leader in every sense of the game.
Yeah, good hustle there. They got a bit lucky there on the rebounds. Eventually got it, but we see Christofferson checking back in here.
And it looks like Bakken Bears have spotted a bit of a weakness for Hibernia. They know they're short on size, not to mind experience. And he can use that big Danish rear end of his to really put the muscle on, but it's Juff applying the pressure now on Keelan Cairns and does pick up the possession. And all day long for Bakken Bears, another three-pointer, another open shot that's easily punished, this time by Thomas Lerke, who shoots on sight. He just didn't expect to have such a good look on that one.
Yeah, and Colin O'Reilly calling time out there, he's fairly annoyed, and I'm sure he talked about Lurky. He hasn't done much else in the game, but every time he's got a slip from the three-point line, I think he's 3 from 3 so far. Really hasn't missed. He can't afford to leave him. Open at all. But again, he'd be disappointed mostly because they've had a really good little patch in the game, and then one little lapse in concentration, a turnover from an out-of-bounds play when we were on the offensive end, ends up in a wide-open three-pointer, and it takes the lead back out to 19 points again.
He might shoot on sight, but he really didn't fancy the chest bump off of Kristoffersen on that occasion. And O'Reilly looks like he's reading the riot act to his troops. He's expecting more. You can make excuses for part-timers against full-timers, but there's some basics to basketball that O'Reilly expects to be done, and he has no problem pointing it out when it's not. But of course, we still haven't seen him back out there. Just again, Kristoffersen, we have to remind people again, the largest man in Denmark is currently in Tala. And affords himself a little chuckle there as young Lerke, who is quite the athlete himself, is dwarfed. It's more Game of Thrones than Game of Throws. Here's Roy Downey. Van Zandt, and it's almost another turnover for Hibernia. It's kicked out to Lacey. And Lacey yet to be successful from that kind of range, but does clean it up for Downey, who has had some luck from the perimeter. Hence the attention afforded to him. Covert for Lacey. That's good, smart play when the option wasn't on outside. Lacey eventually pops up and gets back on defense.
Great pass from Colbert onside. Good to see Lacey flash into the basket rather than stick on the three-point line, something we've seen a lot of, but really made a great cut there and an easy two.
And that one settles like a pool ball in the corner pocket to give a 20-point lead for the first time in this game for Bakken Bears. We're midway through the third, and here's Kevin Lacey for Van Zandt. Keeps that ball low and out of trouble and finds Colbert for three. And it's back with Lerke. Finds his point guard. He steps back out of range. And Lerke goes looking for it. It's with Kristoffersen. And that smart play from Limon Colbert inside, not allowing Chris Kristoffersen to use that big behind of his to make gains.
No, Colbert's done excellently on defensively from the very first start. He picked up two cheap fouls, but when it's been one-on-one, he's more than held his own. And we see Conor Riley check back in. And hopefully he is fit to go.
And is this how you deal with a guy who's got that size advantage on you, Matt? You'd know all about it.
Yeah, he just stays there. He makes Kristoffersen hit a long-range kind of hook, and he ends up passing it. But that's all you can do is use your speed when someone's up the size on you. And Colbert did an excellent job there.
Lerke was trying to sniff out the intercept, but it's back with Hibernia. And O'Reilly has checked in now with that squash pass out to Limon Colbert, who would have needed a cape if he was going to make that bucket count. And the ball is back with Bakken Bears.
Yeah, you see Colin drives there. Colbert makes a good choice to go against the small man. He made a good move, and you'd have to say it looked like a bit of a trip, but maybe he lost his balance a little bit too. But over the last couple of minutes, we've seen a little bit more from Sean Van Zandt. He's really started pushing the ball into the key a little bit more and creating a few open looks for people looking to penetrate. You know, I think Bakken, as experienced they are, they tend not to help too much. So Sean might have to look to go a little bit more himself, go away to the basket before they're going to leave the open three-point shooters.
Darko Jukic to Bivia. And Kristoffersen once bitten in the paint, but it's with Jukic. Puts up the runner, Jeff with the offensive rebound.
Yeah, they've gone back into zone there, and you'll see when they are in the zone, they might struggle, especially with the two big guys, Jeff and Kristoffersen, in the game. You see a nice drive, but good defense there from Kearns. Make him take a tough shot, but the two big guys, difficult to box out. Colin ends up taking a foul to prevent the easy 2 points.
And Sebastian Peterson checks into the game once again and is on the ball. Here's Lerke. And that's another substitute. It's back with Lerke. That was Salerts with the three-point attempt. And that's Limon Colbert now moving to three fouls. So if you're over 6'5 and you're playing for Hibernia, you're in foul trouble right now. And Merkus shows with his first attempt that he's much happier shooting from 23 feet away from the basket. Here's Downey, the pressure applied. Downey looks comfortable. Once again, Van Zandt keeping low, driving hard, puts it up. Oh, superb basket there, Sean Van Zandt. With no clear option, he spoke before this game. He can create for himself as well as others. That was a much needed basket from the American.
Yeah, and that basket from Van Zandt, that's what I'd like to see more of, just him penetrating in there until they start to help. At the moment, they're staying at home on the perimeter and not going to miss any three-point shots. Just go at him a little bit, and again, he's gone at him, got called with a foul, so he really has to look. I was going to say he's going to have to look to take advantage, but it looks like he's just gone down with cramp.
And Sean Van Zandt, the player who's playing on the biggest Irish stage and has played on bigger than this. We go back to 2011, and to put the fact that he played an NCAA championship game into perspective for fans, particularly Irish fans, imagine if they put a basketball court in the middle of Croke Park and then filled it, because that was pretty much the arena that he was playing with in 2011 when he went all the way to the college final, shall we say, in American basketball. But it does look like there's a bit of cramp there to the right calf, and he knew it straight away.
Yeah, let's hope it's just come and he'll be able to check back into the game after a little bit of loosened up.
So now it's Hosford. Does it open up for him in the paint? Not quickly enough. Here's Colbert. And there is space here. But it's pulled down by Nikolai Everson and fed to Young Pedersen, back with the Danish captain. Here's Sallerts. And Keelan Cairns tried to get out in front on that one.
Yeah, Kearns trying to fight round, get in front of him, but he's a big body to get round, but that's the fifth foul for Hibernia, so it will be two shots. You see him just trying to get position. Yeah, it's difficult to know what to do when you're so undersized, but fortunately, two shots here.
And there's a picture of Ireland's tallest club player in the reception area of the National Basketball Arena. Jason Killeen, who should have been available for today's game, but a knee injury has ruled him out. And at 6'10", he's our big go-to man. There's a life-size cutout of him in reception. And Christofferson was more than happy to pose for pictures, dwarfing the large Limerick man. And the lead is now 21 points for Back and Bears. There's 2.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. And it looks like Back and Bears then also move on to team fouls. So that will slow down the momentum just that little bit as we head down the stretch. Colin O'Reilly. And O'Reilly is successful at the second attempt to reduce the margin somewhat for now. But Hibernia need a stop. They need a turnover, and it's going to have to come from somewhere. Will it come from a pressure applied at the perimeter? Well,
good defensive set from Hibernia again there in the zone, but this time they really made the extra effort to get out to Lurkey, and he missed his first three-pointer shot of the game. So again, 2 minutes to go. Hibernia can get a score here. They've really had a good quarter.
O'Reilly looking to go coast to coast. He feeds Colbert. And Hibernia will take what they can get at this stage. And two shots from the line will do just fine. Thank you. Nice no-look pass.
There you see great penetration from Colin. And Colbert uses his body. Goes straight at Christofferson. Gets the bump off him. And he goes to the foul line for two shots.
Colbert successful with the first. He's played a lot of minutes in a lot of countries for Hibernia's cause in the last 3 weeks. And that's a timely 2 from 2 from Limon Colbert, reducing the deficit once again back into the teens as Christofferson takes a seat. He knows he's done his job for the while, the 36-year-old.
Fletcher. Bit of full court pressure here. Again, you see the extended zone from Hibernia, something they showed earlier on. They just managed to give up a three to Beavie earlier, but he's not on the court now, and this is where they really need to take advantage when he's gone, because he's obviously he's the key to their offense.
Peterson now says Iris on his jersey, but Sebastian Peterson. That one went into the corner for Colbert to claim the rebound, and feed Hosford pulls up, finds Keelan Cairns, a little bit pedestrian on that right wing from Hibernia. Colbert will inject, he shoots, it's back, back in Bears and Peterson. And Hosford gets whatever he can on that one.
An intentional foul call there, a little bit unlucky, but again, he did take him out. I think it was accidental, but as you see here, Kyle got a bit lucky, used his foot, but then, yeah, it's unlucky, but again, it is an intentional foul. I guess he was clear to the basket. So it'll be two shots and the ball for Hibernia here. So a chance to cut it down to back to the halftime deficit of 16, which would be an excellent result for the quarter so far.
That one eventually finds its way into the basket from Kyle Hosford.
And you see that back and Bears have put Vivia back in. I mean, I think everything's gone through him. And Hibernia did what they had to do. They really took advantage when he wasn't on the floor and got themselves back in this game a little bit here.
Both sides have scored 15 points in this third quarter. It's up to Hibernia and Hosford now to take the impetus and try and close that gap. Short on options, finds Keelan Cairns. And that's a superb three-pointer for the big Belfast man. And just at the right time too, with the clock winding down to the end of this third quarter. Gives the crowd something to cheer about. Hibernia not used to having the crowd on their side. This is their first home game ever. And another easy looking pass, because Bakken Bears have brought back on their star man. It does all go through the Spaniard, playing in his first season in Danish basketball with a Spanish coach.
Yeah, and you just saw again, it all started from the pick and roll, which has allowed Bivia to get to the foul line, going at the big our big guy, I think it was Keelan Cairns inside, shipped it to the corner, and after that we're closing out and chasing the penetration, just leaves Duke inside. It's something that's hounded the Hibernian team throughout the game so far. Hopefully in this last quarter, I mean, when they were in the zone it wasn't such a big issue, but they really try and keep control of this pick and roll offense.
And Jeff improves on his return from the free throw line to push it back out. What can Hibernia do heading down the stretch? Here's Roy Downey. There's a look for him on the right hand side, but he chose to go left and find a teammate. It's back with Downey for 3 points. Roy Downey points to the man who gave him the assist, his Demons teammate, and gets straight back into action on defense. It has a great basket and an equally good return from Tomas Lerke. 15 points between the sides now. It was out into the 20s. Here's Colbert. They may look to run things down here and make sure that they own the ball heading into the break. Here's Hosford. That one's just netted out. A shot to nothing from Nikolai Iverson brings the third quarter to a close, with the gap ever so slightly smaller than it was at halftime here at the National Basketball Arena. Good cheer from the crowd. This team have earned it. And they showed in previous games, particularly the away game to Typhoon, that they can get themselves back into contention in the third, which you wouldn't expect from an amateur team going on against a professional outfit. Israel Martinez has spoken about the conditioning of his side just being a step above. But O'Reilly will have positive things to say to his young troops, and we'll expect to see more of the bench perhaps in the fourth quarter. They trail by 15 points at this stage. Matt, it could be worse.
No, a fabulous quarter from then. I think in the previous games we've struggled with in the third quarter, but that performance there to hold their own but end up winning the quarter, I think Colin will be delighted with that. It really showed. I mean, he twitched up into a zone there, and we'll see from one of their other plays when they did go into the man. We were struggling with the screen and roll earlier on in the game, and here you'll see Bivio has really been at the centre of everything. as the play runs on, it ends up in a screen and roll, which a lot of their man-to-man offenses have ended up in. I think it's Diouf that comes out. Here we go. So Diouf sets a screen, and there Bivia just, he gets to attack the centre, and after that we're always chasing the game a little bit. Ends up with a, it was a good foul in the end to give up, but that's where we've really struggled. If we could take that out of the game, if we could take that out of their game and really get control of the screen and roll, you know, you could get this down to 10 points, maybe even a little bit better. But Colin will be delighted with that quarter. If they can come out and get the first score of this final quarter, then it puts a little bit of pressure on Bakken Bears, which hasn't been the case since the opening couple of minutes.
And if we are to bring the gap down, it's going to be from beyond the perimeter. Cairns on the floor, you've just seen him. Downey can hit it, but he's not out. Van Zandt is, and here he comes. Another big rejection by the Danes. That was Salerts that time, and here he is. Well, if your name is Morgan Salerts, you've just had the best 10 seconds of basketball you'll have all day. Big rejection, followed by a big three. 18-point lead for Bakken Bears.
Good drive from Kyle there, Spitzer. There you see the screen and roll, and this is something we've struggled with. We struggled defensively on it, but offensively, I think once in the first half, you said good screen, and that's really the only time that offensively we've really been able to nail them on the screens, on the screen and roll. But that time they got caught, Kyle split the defense and ended up with a foul. It's really important now that they find their rhythm in this fourth quarter. They haven't so far.
It's just opening up in the back door, but it was shut firmly closed by Bakken Bears. Limon Colbert is looking for some kind of reparation from the referee. But it's a back and ball. Here's Carlos Bivia for Iverson. Erica coming off the screen. Fades away and hit the two, and that 20-point gap has been re-established in this fourth quarter by Bakken Bears. Here's good kick out from Van Zandt. And a good snipe inside from Limon Colbert. Snapples up that rebound off the O'Reilly three, and a good response for Hibernia.
Great penetration from Van Zandt again, and finds O'Reilly wide open, and Colbert did his job staying in there for the rebound.
It's a carbon copy of what we saw him doing in the Men's National Cup of the weekend. And here it is, Bakken trying to do the same. No joy on that occasion for Carlos Bivia. And Hosford goes round, but picks up the foul off Alerka on the way. And with 8.5 minutes to go, Matt, as a coach yourself, at what point do you say, is there any way in which Hibernia can go for broke in this game? Conor Grace has come back in. He's got nothing to lose at this stage.
Yeah, I think against a team of this quality, there'll be no going for broke. I think the way back into their game for them is consistency. They're too good. They're too good a team to try and gamble. Great drive from fans out there, and he's fouled. But yeah, they're too good a team to try and start pressing and expect them to turn the ball over. They showed that the whole game. All Colin can do is keep being consistent to what they've been doing. The zones work a little bit for them, bit of pressure, and just try and whittle down on it one by, you know, point by point. I mean, I think if they can keep it under 20 at the game, Colin would be overjoyed, especially seeing as it was already 16 at the half.
Van Zandt is 32 minutes into his Hibernia basketball career, and you can see already the American is calling more on himself with the drive that time. And two from two because of it.
Yeah, he's come into the game this second half. Talked about just after halftime, wanting to see him push in a bit more, and he certainly has. As the game's gone on, he's got a bit more confidence, got used to the system a little bit more, and a bigger factor in the game.
And for the first time in this game, Bakken Bears American Keane Tolman is on the court. You won't see him too far from that basket. It's out with Salerts. There's Tolman trying to get involved, but it's Colbert finds Grace, and it's back with Kyle Hosford. Superb pass to Grace. Has to go to O'Reilly. It's out for Van Zandt. Can't get around. And the chance is lost, unless Conor Grace can do something. The Bakken Bears are getting closer and closer, and there's four on the shot clock.
And some good defense there from Bakken Bears. on the closeout. Looked a bit like a bow, but again, he moved his body there and they got away with it and forced him to the side. So some good offense, good movement there from Hibernia. As assistant coach James Weldon just calls a timeout for them to talk about it. But again, it's back to 16 points.
And credit to Sean Vincent Van Zandt, one of the only players for Hibernia not to cough up a turnover in this game. Conor Grace being the other one.
Well, I think he just did on the last play, although I think he was a bit unlucky because it looked to me like it touched someone's hand on the way out, but it was given against them. But 7:40 to go. You know, I think Colin's message will be, let's keep playing, let's keep moving the ball. You see him talking there about the areas of they put pressure in and making cuts and stuff. It's important not to stand and watch now. What they have done in some of the games when they've got a little bit tired is rely on three-point shots. You know, we struggle offensively to get rebounds, so it's important to keep the energy up, keep playing, keep making the cuts, keep moving the ball and rebounding, keep them in the game. That's what's really been successful for them in the second half. And if they can keep on doing that, you know, if they could tie this second half, that would be a tremendous result and a real step up from what they've done from the previous three games.
And this was hard work from Hibernia, but a harder work.
Yes,
from
you see there, I think it was Lurky there. Could have been called a foul, but probably good defense in the end. And this is where they just turn it over, and it looks like it could have come off his hand, but great defense there.
And Colin O'Reilly trying to call plays on his Strathboard in the Hibernia basketball timeout. Has to be careful that he's not dripping sweat down onto the play he's just called. It's tough going for the player coach, but he's giving it everything.
Great defense there. He stepped over in the backcourt. They really put the pressure on there, came out with timeout, a trap by O'Reilly and Hosford, and I think it was Dukic just went backcourt there, so a good turnover and a great start out of the timeout, exactly as drawn up by Coach O'Reilly.
So possession for the home team, who had to work so hard on their last one to get anything out of it. So they'll need something here to give the sense of momentum, and it's Colbert. Took on his compatriot there. Couldn't finish over Keen Tolman. It's back with Back and Bears, and it's opened up for Jukic. No joy for Tolman. And luckily, it's the home side maintaining possession there.
It's just that little bit of concentration there they have to keep, not take it too easy. You know that Back and Bears will never be too far away, as Tolman just missed an easy one there. Just took his eye off the ball, and as always, Vivian's right there.
Well, when you scan down the team sheet and you see USA beside one of the players, there's an assumption if they've made it to Europe, they've got something about them, but we haven't seen it from Keith Coleman yet. Colbert, however, pumps the fists. That's a big two and a chance to make it a three-point play from Hibernia's American.
Yeah, I think you hit the nail on the head there, and I think Colbert knew it from the first game too. That he had the match. You see him drives there, puts the body in, as you see him do every week in the Premier League there. He's too quick, too much talent, too strong for Tom, and then hits a two and makes that a three-point play.
And what's crucial for Hibernia now is that they consolidate on the fact that they've brought themselves back into this game. 13 points between the sides. As we head down the stretch, is not one that many would have given this part-time Irish side. But that is the difference from all at 26 feet. The buzzer beater from the classy operator that is Carlos Bivia.
Yeah, that's got to hurt. Fantastic defense. And right on the shot clock buzzer, they nail that down. But I mean, it was 13 there, it's back to 16 again. Hibernia just have to keep playing for this last 16. I was looking up some of the results that they've had this year in the Danish League, and they've been winning by 40 points, 30 points. So you have to say it's a fantastic second half so far. It's a, as you see, huge shot by Bivia there. And from the way he walked out and let it go, it was never missing in his mind.
He didn't even crack a smile. Here's Sean Van Zandt. And it has. Levon Colbert, it was loose, it was messy, and it was enough for Levon Colbert, who again is trying to rally the troops at this stage.
And you can see there from the annoyance of the of Bakken's coach there when he just got the ball to wipe it down. You know, he's annoyed. He thinks they should win by more, so that has to be a positive for Hibernia. They've been excellent, as I say, to this point, and it's 6 minutes left in this game that they really have to push on, see if they can get it to single figures, maybe even put a bit of a scare on the Bears.
So there's 6 minutes remaining. It would be remarkable if Hibernia could get closer, particularly with the kind of form Bakken Bears Spaniard is in today. He, in many ways, has been the difference between two sides who should be poles apart. They are at opposite ends of the Group F table, and it's out for Lerca. And that's good pressure there from Hibernia, who break. And it eventually drops for Limon Colbert, and that's the biggest cheer you've heard from the Tala faithful this evening, as Van Zandt and Colbert combine. And it's been quite a while since we've seen just 12 points between the sides, and that's a third personal foul as well for Bakken Bears. A little bit of foul trouble starting to creep in on this side.
Here we go here. So Lurk eventually misses the shot, but you see Limon Colbert, see how much effort he makes to get down the court. Fantastic at this time of the game. Gets all the way down the middle of the lane as his foul going to the basket, and a superb finish then. That's what we want to see from Hibernia, that kind of up and down basketball. And he's a chance to pull it back down to 11 points, which is fantastic as he makes a fist pump on the floor there.
So he's got a shamrock on his jersey, but this is a passion play from the American. Maybe too much blood pumping there as he misses with the and one.
Huge defensive set here. If they can get a stop here, they have a chance to get it down to 10 or even 9 with a three. So massive effort here for Hibernia.
And Jukic inside for Jof. And Jof was maybe the missing link for Bakken Bears in the last few possessions, but it wasn't successful on that occasion. Now it's opened up for Colin O'Reilly. And Colbert is heating up, but he won't chance it from the three-point line. It's inside. Big finish, Limon Colbert. Great pass, Kyle Hosford. And now this is just a 10-point game with less than 5 minutes to go in this FIBA Europe Cup tie.
And for the first time in the game there, we see Bakken Bears pick and roll defense break down, and a magnificent pass from Hosford there. They've got another miss and a chance to make it single figures.
And Jukic can keep spinning because that one's not going in, but here's Colin O'Reilly. And that would have lifted the roof. O'Reilly's pretty much first three-point attempt of the evening. Has handed the possession back to Bakken Bears. Still a 10-point game.
Yeah, and Colbert's looking for a break there. They've sent Keelan Kearns to the bench, but see O'Reilly.
And Bears let off the hook there with the open three. It's fired down court, but it's back with Jukic.
Yeah, you see O'Reilly tell Coach Weldon to call a timeout rather than make a sub. He's happy with a five on the floor here as they've got it to 10 points with a chance there on the fast break to get it up, but just missed.
Jukic doesn't collect cleanly, but beats O'Reilly and feeds Lerca. And a three-point jumper from Lerca restores a decent advantage, and the pressure's applied.
Oh,
and that's how it's done in the big leagues. Bang, bang, 16 points between the sides.
Just a huge error there, and O'Reilly's rightly annoyed. He'd made the call in the last play when it was a 10-point game to not sub but call a timeout. They made a three, and as you see, Van Zandt down again. They made a three, and whilst they're waiting for a timeout to be called, it was. I'm not sure if the mistake was with the table or with the coaching staff, but the timeout wasn't called. They got a turnover, made another three, and now all of a sudden it's back to 16.
Credit to the sportsmanship of Carlos Bivia. He picked his spot, he took his time, he nailed the three, and then he turned around and gave a bit of a hand to the stricken Sean Van Zandt, who pulls up a cramp for the second time in this game. And to be fair to Van Zandt, he's a genuine athlete. He walks around like he's got two coiled springs in his trainers. But this is a step above for anyone in a Hibernia jersey this evening, whether you've done it all in front of 70,000 or you do it week in, week out in front of 70.
Yeah, I'm seeing the last 2 minutes has really been fantastic basketball from Hibernia. They've got themselves back in the game, got it down to 10 points and put Bakken Bears under huge pressure. It wasn't for the sake of them missing shots. You know, Hibernia made them turn the ball over, made them miss shots. and they create opportunities which they put in down the other end. It's just again we see that lapses, two lapses in quick succession, two quick threes in the space of, they must have been in the space of 5 seconds, and it's back to 16 after all the hard work that they've done. And
this is how you win a game of basketball. So from 10 to 16, like it was no thing, Black and Bears in control. But Roy Downey in possession, and you get the feeling a triple from the team in white would do just nicely around now, but the pressure's on from Back and Bears.
The shot off at four, and went up time
in. Gonna have to go up. And that is absolutely clinical from Back and Bears. Exactly what their coach wanted from them, following up from those two trays. And here's Mikael Plantin back in the game. We haven't seen him in a while. And Downey puts the hand up to acknowledge the foul. That brings him, that's actually his third personal foul.
So this second team foul for Hibernia, and as O'Reilly comes out for Kev Lacey. That just shows the kind of pressure that Hibernia put on Back and Bears in the second half with Back and on 5 points. They've really taken two of them in this quarter and in the third quarter. We just need to try and finish this game out now. It's 3 points, so they can cut this lead a little bit away with 3 minutes to go.
And it's the starting five for Back and Bears back on the floor as they look to close out this Group F encounter.
Bivio just hits again. That's 19 for Bivio, and he's really been a thorn in the side. As I said, he gets another steal.
And the simplest of finishes for the Spaniards. You'd argue worth the price of the admission fee alone to see what he's been capable of this afternoon. This is the first time, this evening I should say, this is the good response there from Kyle Hosford.
Great move from Hosford there. He saw he had a mismatch with Juf Gard and went straight at him, and a nice floating finish over the top. But he said, Bivia, he's done everything for Back and Bears today, both inside, outside, 3 points, won the show.
This one's claimed by Connor Grace for Hosford. And conditioning-wise, it's one of the fittest on the floor for Hibernia, and he'll need that energy down the stretch. So too will Downey. And it's ended up with Downey. But smart play there from Downey, as he has done enough to retain possession. And you can see the Back and Bears are cheering their point guard off the floor, and one or two rounds of applause from the home fans as well. Hosford once again with the drive, and that's a good response as he shows that he has plenty left to offer in this game. Still though, 17 points between the sides.
Another great finish from Hosford there. He goes up and over, that's what we see him do regularly. And he's got aggressive in this last couple of minutes.
More Route 1 stuff. Jeff lurking, poaching, taking his two. And it just deadens the legs of Hibernia a little bit as Hosford uses Colbert for protection. Colbert feeds Grace. And now it's the home fan, now it's the traveling fans who are in full voice. They have built the lead back out down this stretch.
Lamont Colbert just checks out the game there. He's had a fantastic game. Foul trouble early, kind of stopped our little mini run at the start of the game, but when he came back in, he's really held his own inside, put in a huge shift for Hibernia basketball today.
And Connor Grace has poured as much sweat onto this floor as anyone this evening, and it's taken his eye out for the free throw attempt. And Hosford can't stop Peterson legally. Gives the referee a chance to blow the whistle. And there's just 70 seconds left in this game now, Matt.
Well, I think right now, below us here, the subs come in. You're seeing what Hibernia have accomplished today. The fact that Back and Bears are only just emptying their bench with 1 minute, 8 seconds to go. That hasn't happened in any of the three previous away games. And certainly against Back and Bears, I mean, they were playing in the third quarter the last time. So it just shows that Hibernian really put it to back in base today and put up a huge performance.
Aladin Barraquet and Nielsen are the subs on. But it's Juff the professional who will help back and close out this game. Hibernia have already surpassed their highest total for their campaign to date as they amass 67 points. It won't be enough today. Good work from Lacey, but he can't cleanly retrieve that offensive rebound. And what most people were thinking of today, the spread was 27 and a half points, Matt. There's 21 between them now and 30 seconds on the clock. Small gains ahead of a matchup next week that Hibernia have always targeted. And there's just no let up from Michel Juff. Professionals don't go easy, no matter who they're playing. And back in her at 90 points. Here's Roy Downey. There's Connor Grace. Downey looking for the opportunity. This will be the last shot of the game if it goes up. Kyle Hosford lets the buzzer run down on the fourth of Hibernia Basketball's games in this Group F of the FIBA Europe Cup. The search for a win continues. They've been beaten by 90 points to 67. They've beaten the spread. It won't come as much consolation to them, Matt, but there will be things that they'll have to and need to take positives out of ahead of the trip of Typhoon from Slovenia all the way to Dublin next week.
Yeah, I think you have to look at the quality they were playing against. I mean, they're top of the group. They've beaten the group favourites, and barring a shock result tonight, they've probably qualified from this pool already with this win tonight. Looking at the scoreboard, Colin, be a little bit disappointed it was 23, because I think they played and deserved to be closer than that. You know, getting it down to 10 with something like 3:30 to go and just a couple of mistakes should have shot it back out to 16 points. But from a development point of view, where they've come from the start, to the fact that Bakken could only play their bench in the last minute of the game, they really showed that they've improved over the three games. They've learned from their three away games. You know, and now in their position, especially next week when we play the team from Slovenia, that's probably one of the weaker ones in the group. As you see the Bakken Bears celebrating in front of their fans, it really gives us an opportunity and some positivity to put up a huge performance next week, and hopefully people watching tonight will actually come to the venue next week and really put a bit of awe behind this Hibernia team, because they really fought well tonight and deserved to be a little bit closer, I think, in the end.
And it's just been the timing of Bakken Bears throughout the 40 minutes when they've had to put up the shots. It's exactly what they've done. Unbelievable stuff, particularly from their Spanish point guards. And you can see the shoulders drop when it goes in from that kind of distance. But Bakken Bears are thrilled. They know they were in a game of basketball. It was closer than Hibernia have gotten down the stretch. The professionals did what professionals do here at the National Basketball Arena, and it's finished up with a final score of 90 points to 67. Next week, of course, next Wednesday, it is the Slovenian champion, Centur Typhoon, who come to Tala. You can join us once again next week, 7:30 the time, and we look forward to your company at that stage. Stay tuned to those of you watching on our live stream. We'll have the press conference live here shortly, featuring players from both sides. Matt, thanks for joining us.
Welcome. Thoroughly enjoyed it. Really looking forward to the next 2 weeks, and hopefully we'll see bigger and better from Hibernia, but really impressed with the way they fought and the performance they put in today.
Final score in Tala. Hibernia Basketball 67, Bakken Bears 90. Thanks for joining us. of Cobra. Great pass, Kyle.
What or okay?
Okay, Coach Martin, we told you on October 28th that we would go deeper into this game with you, and that's what we did. 3.5 minutes to go, 10 points between the sides. What were your thoughts on the game?
Well, I think it's tonight we did history again in the club, in Bears team. It's our third time. We qualified to the second round in the Europe Cup. This means that Denmark, especially Aarhus, have a potential basketball club like Bakken Bears. And then for that reason, we are very happy. And then also, I want to say thank you to all our sponsors and friends and everybody who came from Aarhus to support the team. This is very nice for us. We feel today like we are playing at home. So thank you for the support to our sponsors. And now I will talk about the game. Of course, it was a tough game. We know that when you play the second time against the same team, you know, it's even more difficult. They got a new player today also, one shooting guard, so we didn't know too much about him before. But the thing, in general lines, I think it was a team win. I think everybody who participated on the court, defense, you know, I think we are a solid team on defense. Of course, always we can improve, but we need time for practice because now it's just a game, day off, game, day off, game. Just we need to take care about the players, about we need for them everybody healthy. But we show today character. I think same thing like we play away against Nymburk, another difficult court, you know. And then that's it. Also, I would like to say to Hibernia for his hospitality in these 2-3 days we have been here in Ireland. Hotel and everything was really good, not complaining. So I will support this project for them also. I think it's a good step for them. You're welcome.
Más o menos.
Hubo muchos momentos en el partido que Hibernia apretó, se acercaron, pero bueno, en ese momento llegó balón a tus manos y metiste puntos importantes.
Hibernia believe in all the game in they can win. So it's difficult to play with it. And they switched the defense the last quarter, and for us is we didn't find the easy solution. But sometimes the more easy is pick and roll. If the ball go in, we win, no?
Nice. Okay. If the ball go in, we win,
you're making it, yeah.
So Bernie Blair, coach Colin O'Reilly. Colin, you promised him to go deeper into the game. 10-point game with 3.5 minutes to go. And professionals just did what professionals do.
Yeah, I guess you could say that. You know, we had a good look for three to cut it to a 7-point game. They come down and hit a 3-pointer, and we can't get the timeout quick enough. So that's, you know, that didn't didn't cost us the game, but it made it a 23-point game in the end. For us, it's a very positive step. Again, we got it was the first time we're coming out of timeouts, coming out of halftime, where we were able to get good looks that we had drawn up. So the players are finally comfortable. They're starting to believe in themselves, believe in their ability, and I guess that's what a home court advantage does to you. It gives you an extra split second on the ball. So, you know, for us, it's a great positive. Now we have to move on from here. You know, it's great having positives, but it's still a 23-point loss, and we have to find that extra few percentages ourselves to make sure we continue for the 40 minutes, because, you know, it's right there. We've got a chance next week at home against a team we feel we can compete against, with a few different tweaks, a few different wrinkles here and there, and we feel, you know, if we can put up 67 points again next week and play that last 4 minutes of the game, we've got a very good chance of winning.
Definitely. I think today, like Colin said, we were able to stick with our game plan a lot longer. Guys weren't taking a step back when the pressure came on. If anything, we were attacking a bit more when that happened. So, I mean, we talk about this a lot. It's a step up in level, and you can't replicate that step. So with the four games that guys have had, it's a great experience for them, and guys are starting to grow into it. And when the pressure comes on, there's no stepping back. They recognize that they can compete at this level. And like Colin said, there was a minute there that kind of pushed the lead out on us, but we were happier with the length of our performance today.
Yeah, hopefully. You know, I think there was a bit of, not a whole lot of understanding about what we're trying to do with this group, you know, but from players' point of view, we did hear them when we got back in the game. We did feel as if, you know, the backing crowd did go quiet for a few minutes there, and we did feel the support. But if we can throw another 200 or 300 people on top of that, and they're in here from the start, getting us pumped up, you know, I think everyone, the players, which people are forgetting, they're looking at Hibernia as a single entity. You have to look at these players will go home to their clubs now tomorrow, clubs that they've represented all their careers. And this is part of what they've done with their clubs, you know, so it's a huge honour for the players. And I think all the clubs need to get behind that for their own players' sake. Forget about if they're coming supporting Hibernia, they're coming supporting their own club members, their own, you know, basketball as a whole. It's a small community. We've got to get behind each other. And I think tonight's performance, hopefully, opened a few eyes, you know. Again, people will look at the score and say 23-point defeat, what a, not great. But for us and for anyone that was here, that wasn't a 23-point game. And I think it was an enjoyable game for both sets of fans. And I think it's something that, you know, if we can get a few more people into the arena next week from the start of the game and get the crowd enthusiastic from the start, then, you know, let's see what happens then.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
If you can't, you're doing it. I don't think I'll take any.
What? I wouldn't wish it.
But you know what I mean? You don't have to be worried about spread.
Everything goes down there. Ooh. Yeah. Great. It's on the one. Last year we were only at break.
That's it.